students, welcome to the class of Editorial Decode, and in this class I will be decoding Federalism, Nepal's Final Frontier, written by Jayant Prasad. Now from examination point of view, this will help you in General Studies Mains Examination Paper 2. Plus this is very very important for Political Science optional students. Now what is this editorial about? This editorial is about the precipitousness and about the disenchantment and dissatisfaction being shown by the Madeshi community. This editorial is also about the inability and the lack of the seriousness on the part of the Maoist parties and Madeshi parties to solve this intricate problem of federalism. Now, in order to properly understand this editorial, we need to know something about the history of Nepal, history from 2007-8. Now, this was a period when Nepal, because of the pressure that was exerted by the Maoists and the Madeshi parties, that it was decided that the Nepal would be moving to a federalism. Nepal would be moving to republicanism. Nepal would be moving towards secularism. And in order to achieve these three aims, secularism, republicanism and federalism, the Constituent Assembly was elected in year 2008. But after that, the entire work of the Constituent Assembly, it got into status quoism. It was not able to generate any result. Now, why it was not able to generate any result? And in order to know that, we must know about the type of the political parties who are functioning in Nepal. Kaun-kaun si parties function karenge Nepal mein? Unka pata hona bahut zaruri hai. That will give us an idea about why this conflict has delayed so much, why it had continued and sustained so much. First of all, there is a political party that is known as Nepali Congress. Then we have got Communist Party of Nepal, Unified Communist Party of Nepal, Marxist and Leninist. Then we have got Communist Party of Nepal, Maoist, Unified Communist Party of Nepal, Maoist. So basically, there is a Marxist-Leninist party, there is a Maoist party, there is a Congress party, and there is a party who is working for the rights of the Madeshis. When the first Constituent Assembly was formed, it failed to generate any result. And then again the Constituent Assembly was elected. In the first Constituent Assembly, the Maoists, they had secured more number of votes with respect to the Congress and the Marxist and the Leninist. But in the second Constituent Assembly that was elected, the Congress won more number of seats than the Maoists. Then the Congress, in coalition with Marxist Leninist and themselves, they ended up forming a government in Nepal. And it is these parties who are presiding over the formation of the new constitution. So the new Constituent Assembly that was elected in 2013, it had decided to solve all the intricate problems that the Nepal was facing. Kaun-kaun si problem hai? The main problem is to decide about ki wahan pe federalism kaisa hona chahiye. Jo Maoists hai aur jo Madeshi communities hai, वो चाहती हैं कि जो कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन जो संविधान वहां पे लिखा जाए जो फेडरलिज्म का वहां पे बेसिस होना चाहिए इट शुड बी द एथनिसिटी बट ऑन द अदर हैंड द कांग्रेस एंड द मार्क्सिस्ट एंड द लेनिनिस्ट दे डोंट वांट एथनिसिटी टू बी द बेसिस ऑफ फेडरलिज्म इन नेपाल ऐसा वो क्यों चाहते हैं वो कहते हैं कि अगर एथनिसिटी बेसिस बन जाएगा फेडरलिज्म का नेपाल में इट विल क्रिएट कैओस इट विल क्रिएट कॉन्फ्लिक्ट इट विल क्रिएट फॉल्ट लाइन इट विल क्रिएट फिसिपरेशनेस इन नेपाल बट ऑन द अदर हैंड मदेशीज दे आर हेल बेंट ऑन टू टेक नेपाल ऑन टू द लैंडस्केप ऑन टू द टेरिटरी विच इज डिसाइडेड मोर बाय एथनिसिटी नाउ इन ऑर्डर टू अंडरस्टैंड दिस इंटायर कॉन्फ्लिक्ट Like the conflict was resolved, the Constituent Assembly has decided to go in for a seven state Nepal. But why this conflict is getting boiled up again and again? Now, why the Madeshi community is lying, who resides in the Terai region that is more close to India, why they feel more disenchanted now, why they have resorted to the way of violence, why they have resorted to the way of conflict? Abhi unko kya problem ho gaya hai? The problem, if you want to know the real reasons about the problem, you will be required to understand this entire international politics. And in the international politics, there are two countries that are playing the role. One is China and the other one is India. Now the Indians, they are having more affinity towards this Terai community people, to the Madeshi communities. Terai mein 51% of the population rehta hai Nepal ka. And usme about 20% plus jo Madeshi community hai, they have a close affinity to the Indians. Now the Indian government had not felt good about the way this entire federal structure was being designed in Nepal. Now the Indian community, the Indian government wants that the Madeshi community's interests should be protected. So the entire conflict that is regenerated, that has reflamed, it is nothing but the support of the Indian government plus the support of the mayors who had wanted in the past to create this entire federal structure in Nepal on the basis of ethnicity. Now, like India and China, they have been competing as far as the Nepal is concerned. Now, how they have been competing? Now, as far as China is concerned, it was always interested in making less number of states in Nepal. And this was something that was conveyed to the Nepali dispensation by the Premier of China when he had visited China last year. Now the China government wants that the less number of units should be created. Now why they want the less number of units should be created? They want it because according to them, it will be difficult for them to deal with n number of states if they will be divided on the basis of ethnicity. But on the other hand, India at the face doesn't support this ethnicity based federalism. But implicitly, it really wants that the Nepal to resort to this ethnicity based federalism. Now, why they want it? They want it because by resorting to this ethnicity based federalism, India's interests would be protected because India is more supportive of the Madeshi community that is lying in the Terai region, and this Terai region is close to India. This is the region through which India is having access to the entire Nepal. So the current problem, the current scenario that has unfolded in Nepal, it is nothing but the result of the feeling of disenchantment of the natives of the Madeshi community, plus the involvement of India and China, plus the incapability and the incapacity of the Congress, the Madeshi, the Maoists and the Marxists, and the Madeshi political parties to solve this entire problem. Now this problem has procrastinated a lot. Bahut zyada lamba khich gaya hai ye problem. 2007-08 ke ye constitution bana rahe hain, 2015 bhi jane wala hai, and abhi tak inse conflict dur nahi hua, samvidhan inse abhi tak achhi tarah nahi bana hai. Kya Nepal federalism hoga, wo ye decide nahi kar pa rahe, kis tarah ka federalism hoga, abhi decide kar liye, but there is a conflict. Secularism kaise inko evolve karana hai Nepal mein, wo bhi abhi tak decide nahi ho paya. So this is all for the editorial decode. You can subscribe to this channel. Name of the channel is EIAS Mentors. You can contact me at 845-94-0000 in case you are interested in buying the video classes on entire civil services preparation. And to view the information of the classes that we are offering, please visit our websites eiasmentors.com and brainiki.com. And in case you have liked this video, do click on the like button, do share and comment on this video. And plus, we have also launched the app 2 years ago, and the name of the application is Brainiki. You can find that application from Google Play Store and from App Store. And this was all for the day. Bye bye. Take care. Have a nice day.